In this Snyk introduction, I'll show you how to add Snyk to your development environment, find and fix known vulnerabilities in the open source libraries your app depends on, and continue to protect your projects. We'll start by choosing the repositories we want Snyk to protect. Snyk will find the manifest files from each of these projects, understand the direct and indirect dependencies, and flag those with known vulnerabilities. You can immediately see which projects are vulnerable via the GitHub integration, and you'll get the same results using Snyk's command line interface. Let's drill deeper into the goof project. We can see more details about each vulnerability. Finding these issues is important, but it isn't the goal. Fixing them is. By clicking the Open a Fix PR button, Snyk lets you pick which vulnerabilities you want to fix and automatically opens a pull request with the minimum changes needed to make them go away. Et voila! On the Files Change tab, we can see Snyk has already updated dependency versions and created new patches. This pull request can now be merged. Now the project is protected, we want to keep it that way. Every future pull request, including this one, will run the same tests to flag when you introduce new security flaws or bad licenses. This prevents you from introducing new vulnerabilities, like in this example, while you are fixing the existing ones. Additionally, when a newly disclosed vulnerability affects an existing dependency, Snyk's daily testing will notify you via your preferred channel, as well as by automatically opening a fixed PR as we can see here. To learn more about these and other great features such as governance and reporting, container scanning, Snyk's extensive language ecosystem support, sign up for free on the Snyk homepage and start securing your applications today.